Good evening. My name is Benny Harms, and it's great to welcome you back here this Holy Week as we think about the thoughts of Jesus in the evenings of the week. I want to read to you from Mark's Gospel, chapter 11, from verse 12 onwards. The next morning, as they were leaving Bethany, Jesus felt hungry. He noticed a fig tree a little way off in full leaf. So he went to see if he could find any figs on it. But there were only leaves, because it was too early in the season for fruit. Then Jesus said to the tree, "May no one ever eat fruit off you again." And the disciples heard him say it. When they arrived back in Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple and began to drive out the merchants and their customers. He knocked over the tables of the money changers and the stalls of those selling doves, and he stopped everyone from bringing in merchandise. He taught them, "The scriptures declare, 'My temple will be called a place of prayer for the nations,' but you have turned it into a den of thieves." When the leading priests and teachers of religious law heard what Jesus had done, they began planning how to kill him. But they were afraid of him because the people were so enthusiastic about Jesus' teaching. That evening, Jesus and the disciples left the city. If ever I've wanted to write a book, it would be based on John's Gospel, chapter 2 and verse 15, where we are told that Jesus stood aside from everybody in the temple and plaited a whip. He did this from cords that were there. And he used it to clear the temple of the people and animals. I would call it plaiting the whip. There's a lot of supposition around why Jesus found it necessary to make a whip in the first place. What was the need? Perhaps the need was more for him to get it together to calm himself down than the physical need for a whip. Although you would have needed something like that to drive out the animals, the scripture tells us quite a few things about Jesus' emotions and feelings. For example, that same day on the way to Jerusalem from Bethany, we are told he was hungry and he went to the fig tree that was in full leaf to see if there were any figs on it. You see, fig trees have leaves before they have fruit, or so I'm told. When he doesn't find any fruit because it's not the right time for the season, he says to the tree, "May no one ever eat your fruit again." Then he goes to the temple. I can't imagine him laughing and cracking jokes with the disciples as he clears the temple. Quite the opposite. Last night I spoke of the condemnation in the eyes of the priests and such like. I think this had probably changed to sheer hatred, because from there on they planned to kill him, but were scared of the people who were enthusiastic about Jesus' teaching. After that, Jesus returned to Bethany. Do you think he regretted clearing out the temple? Do you think that he second-guessed himself like we all do? You know, we're sure of what it is that we do at the moment, and then later on a bit of doubt creeps in, and we're not so certain anymore. I wonder if the disciples steered clear of the boss that evening, having witnessed not only the cursing of the fig tree, but the clearing of the temple, they were sure to stay out of his way. Did the Pharisees meet to plot to kill him? Did they get it together to try and make sure that he would never, ever bother them again? You can bet on it. And then finally, the crowds in the temple. How do you think they felt when they saw everything being turned over, the money changers, the money going everywhere, the animals, just chaos? And then Jesus says, "You have made my house into a den of thieves, whereas Scripture says it should be a place of prayer for the nations." This evening, as the sun sets, my challenge to you is to look back into your own life. The Bible tells us our bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And perhaps this period of being in lockdown and unable to move around freely as you normally would, perhaps this is the time for you to take inner stock of what is there and look deep within. See, is it really a place of prayer or a den of thieves? Do you hear the voice of God, or are there voices other than God's clamoring to take control and to come and steal your peace as well as your inner tranquility? I pray that you will just think about it and allow God to speak to you tonight. Please take the mask off me, make me what I should be, someone who's all for thee, O Lord. Please take the mask off me. Living life for only what it gives me, trying not to get myself involved. Look at me, I stand a lonely hero, while problems in my life remain unsolved. The mask on me. Please take the mask off me, make me what I should be, someone who's all for thee, O Lord. Please take the mask off me. Never sure exactly where I'm going, trying hard to find thy way for me. Never mind to know thee more by praying, nor read thy book the way one learns to see. The mask on me. Please take the mask off me. What I should be, someone who's all for thee, O Lord. Please take the mask off me, someone who's all for thee, O Lord. The mask off me. Good night, and God bless you.